former president also defended his son Eric, claiming he gets treated terribly, just terribly. I think he would like to have a normal life. You tell him, Pops. I want a normal life. Three wives, one porn star, and 20 credible accusations of assault, just like my dad. You know who else is normal, Dad? Hugs. Grisham also goes after the former president's family. For instance, she reveals that at the 2017 White House Easter egg roll, Don Jr., Eric, and their families cut other kids in line so they could be photographed with the president. Let me get this straight. They cut a bunch of little kids in line so they could be first to get a picture with their own dad, like he's a character at Disney World. Dad, please take a picture with me. I already got Tigger and Gaston. I also asked Gaston to take me fishing. He said no. No one hugs like my dad, beats up thugs like my dad. No one snorts lots of ADD drugs like my dad. Scene. I want to thank the Academy. Here's how Eastman's evil plan was supposed to work. Pence would throw out those seven states' electoral votes because they allegedly had competing electors. In fact, no state had actually put forward an alternate slate of electors. They were merely the former president's allies claiming, without any authority, to be electors. I can be an elector, Dad! I hereby name you King President Dad the Second. Now can we play catch? Cohen got off of house arrest just yesterday, and his first stop was CNN.
I do want to make this promise to you and to all of your viewers that I may have been prosecuted, and right now I am the only one, but I will not be the only one at the end of the...
For this crime?
For this crime and for others.
Who else was involved?
Well, there were quite a few people that were involved. Eric Trump was involved.
Help me, Dad! Dad, help! I'm too pretty for jail. It'll destroy Mom. Also, second Mom, third Mom, and porn star Mom. She's the only one who still calls me. But it looks like, thank you. Thank you. Now, usually, when the former president appoints someone who is grossly incompetent to an important position, he has a good reason. They're related to him. That means the only reason Nunes got this gig is because Jared, Don Jr., and Eric all turned it down. Sorry, Dad, no can do. That job is beneath me. But I'd still like to be considered for the role of chief executive hug receiver. Bring it in. Bring it in, Dad. Let the healing begin. Republicans were quick to point the finger, including the former president, who called on Biden to resign in disgrace over Afghanistan. Pretty weird to blame Biden for withdrawing troops when this summer he was claiming credit for it.
I started the process. All the troops are coming back home. They couldn't stop the process. 21 years is enough, don't we think? 21 years. They couldn't stop the process. They wanted to, but it was very tough to stop the process.
Yes, they wanted to, but they couldn't stop the process. It's also how he describes the birth of Eric. Dad! Dad, it's your little quagmire! It's too late to withdraw from me. Here's what Eric told the Fox and Friends today.
My father's in there, and he's fighting every single day. And he has to fight against the media, and he has to fight against these lunatics. And guys, I'm telling you, 95% of this country is behind him in this message.
Yeah, 95. I'm telling you. No. ...95% is behind my dad, okay? Okay, you better check my math, okay? He lost the popular vote, okay?
Uh-huh.
Lowest
uh-huh.
approval rating of all time, and it's a bunny! Hi, Mr. Bunny! Dad, can I keep him? Can I? Wait, come back! Come back, Mr. Bunny! Come back! Come back! I love you! I love you! Of course, no presidency is without its scandals, and Biden has had a few with presidential dog Major Biden. After moving into 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, Major made headlines for having two biting incidents in less than a month. One more, and he'll beat the record held by Eric. Stephen Miller smelled wrong. I thought he was an intruder. I'm sorry. Eric had a lot to say, which is a big change. Yesterday, this is true, the New York Attorney General's office asked to have Eric testify in an inquiry into whether the Trump Organization committed fraud. He wasn't feeling that chatty then. Instead, he decided to take the fifth. No surprise, Eric's been taking the fifth for years in Trump's ranking of his children. But pleading the fifth can seem incriminating, according to Eric's dad, who said this in 2016 about his Democratic opponent.
Just people taking the Fifth Amendment. You see, the mob takes the fifth. If you're innocent, why are you taking the Fifth Amendment?
Oh, no, I'm just like Hillary Clinton. Lock me up. Lock me up. I'm sorry, Dad. Hello, my name is Eric. Would you like a booth in the front or the back? Our special tonight is Scrod. Today, the Senate heard closing arguments from both sides, and Adam Schiff told the senators that if they don't hold Trump accountable for seeking foreign interference in an election, there's no bottom to what he'll try next.
Trump could offer Alaska to the Russians in exchange for support in the next election, or decide to move to Mar-a-Lago permanently and let Jared Kushner run the country.
Wow. Wow, not even in Adam Schiff's worst nightmare scenario do Eric and Don Jr. get any responsibility. Quick, Don! God, come quick! Adam! Quick, Don! Adam Schiff is talking about who Dad would give power to, and damn it. Does this mean I have to call Jared Daddy now? Last night, he said this on the Fox News.
They'll probably find a note from me telling him how proud I am of him and what a great job he was doing as president.
Hey, FBI! Hey, FBI, did you find my note telling my dad how proud I am of him? Did you find a note of him saying how proud he is of me? Keep looking. The truth is out there. And in here. There was one inconsistency to Eric's story about how the former... Really? Wow. It's been a long... There was one inconsistency to Eric's story about how the former president learned about the raid yesterday morning. See if you can spot it.
You were with your dad as this was unfolding?
I was, Sean. In fact, I was the guy that got the call this morning, and I called my father and let him know that it happened.
So, you were with your dad yesterday morning as it was unfolding, and you got the call that it was happening, so you called him to tell him it was happening? From the same room? Hold on, it went to voicemail. He's not picking up. Dad, it's me. Dad, it's me over here. Dad, it's me, your son. Not the one you like, the other one. I have terrible news. I'm in the room with you. Eric jumped on the rage wagon to explain how he knew this was a political hit job on his dad.
Make no mistake, Jesse. I mean, I know the White House as well as anyone. I spent a lot of time there. I know the system. This did not happen without Joe Biden's explicit approval. The White House approved of this.
If there's one thing I learned from my dad's time in the office, it's that the president definitely interferes with the Justice Department. That thing? No, I'm serious. I am serious as a heart attack. Heart attack. Nothing happens without his approval, except me.
A hunting organization has just announced that they will be auctioning off a dream hunt with Donald Trump Jr. Wow. I mean, should that even be legal? I mean, he's the president's son. I don't think that's... Oh, okay. Yeah, sure. I thought that's different. I just... Yo, hunt with. That seems much... That's much more sense. Yes, makes much more sense. Because the other thing was wrong. Wrong.
No, it's not him.
Not good.
No.
Turns out what you're actually bidding on is an Alaska yacht-based Sitka black-tailed deer hunt with Donald Trump Jr. That's too many things. That's too many things in one thing. You got to keep it simpler for Don Jr. He'd be just as happy whipping light bulbs at an old van in the woods. Eric, go stand by the van. I don't want to. Stand by the van, you butt face. Come on. Catch it. All of this tweeting has some people worried. As another former official put it, he was never completely hinged. The trip from where he was to unhinged, as he is now, that was not a long trip. Okay. Okay.
He just had to walk around the corner.
No. Uh-huh. Let me get this straight. We've got a man alone in a big house, typing nonsense and slowly going insane. Oh, it sounds like that new sequel to The Shining, The Whining. Here's Danny. And I think we know who the spooky twins would be. Come play with us forever and ever. Wow, there's a lot of blood in this elevator. Trump made a farewell visit to the city this weekend for a UFC event, and New Yorkers showed him just how much he'll be missed. What the hell? That should be Trump's crowd. Do you know how hard it is for an old white guy to get booed at a UFC event? It's the official sport of men who buy their groceries at the gas station. Let's see, I got the jerky, I got the Slim Jims, I got the pork rinds, vegetable. Pringles. Eric Trump leapt to his dad's defense on Twitter.
At hashtag UFC244, chanting Donald Trump, USA, USA.
Which he somehow tried to prove with a still photo.
I got your back, Dad. Look, those weren't boos. Those were cheers. Just listen to this picture I took. Shh. You gotta listen real close. You could hear him cheering for my dad. I can hear him saying, Eric, I love you.
Now, who knows what's gonna happen here, okay? It's anybody's guess. But the phone call is pretty damning. So, this afternoon, a visibly miffed, but also kind of exhausted, Donald Trump talked about the call with reporters at the UN and said, yeah, it could have been worse.
There was no pressure. The way you had that built up, that call, it was going to be the call from hell. It turned out to be a nothing call, other than a lot of people said, I never knew you could be so nice.
Yes. Yes. It's true. People did not know that Trump could be so nice, specifically Don Jr. and Eric.
Wait, Dad, you offered to give stuff to that Ukrainian guy? Why'd you offer that guy stuff? I thought you said presents for the week. Santa's gonna get an earful from me in my next letter. He also insisted He also insisted remember a couple years ago when Trump first got into office? We were all so nervous that Donald Trump was some sort of sleeper agent who was going to sell America out to a foreign power behind our backs. Well, it's Throwback Thursday. Because we just learned that this summer, Donald Trump had a phone call with a foreign leader that was so troubling that it prompted an official in the U.S. intelligence community to file a formal whistleblower complaint when Trump was overheard making a promise to a foreign leader. Yeah, a promise.
What in the
to
world?
An unknown foreign leader. Thank God Trump never keeps his promises. Never. Never has. Eric.
I don't recall him keeping promise. Yeah.
In fact, Eric is still waiting by the front door to go to Disney World. Hi-ho. Hi-ho, hi-ho, you promised that we'd go. The intelligence community, these kind of intelligence documents, keep in mind, are so top secret, the president himself has to declassify them so other people can see it. Even our senior national security officials are not allowed to see them without specific permission, and the fact that he had them is completely indefensible. So the people trying to defend him are instead focusing on the evidence picture the FBI took of them on the carpet. Like the ex-president's son, Eric.
I can tell you, my father's a very, very neat guy. He doesn't leave documents staged all over an office floor.
My dad. No, I mean this. This is important. This is important. Quiet, y'all. Listen up. My dad does not leave documents all over the floor, okay? His crime is organized. What? What did I say? No one ever tells me what I say. Because no one is listening. Here's the deal. Judge Ketanji Brown Jackson explicitly rejected that logic, writing, "Presidents are not kings." True. Very true. But
that leaves it out right there. Come on, Ketanji.
I will say, Eric Trump does look royal family inbred. My bones are like Twizzlers. In court, Donald Trump admitted to shocking misuse of his charity funds, including giving his own presidential campaign $2.8 million from a veterans fundraiser and spending $10,000 on a portrait of himself. It is so beautiful. It's like a mirror that doesn't know when I'm naked. This I like. Trump's three adult children were officers of the foundation. And as part of the settlement, Eric, Don Jr., and Ivanka were ordered to undergo mandatory training to ensure they do not engage in similar misconduct in the future. Well, that must have been a big day for Eric. Guys, it was so fun. It was so fun to hang out together in mandatory charity class. Hey, let's have a class reunion right now. Come back. Come back, I'll give you money to stick around. Isn't that how charity works? Love me. We're also less than 6 months away from the 2018 midterm elections, when Democrats are hoping to take back the House and possibly even the Senate. But Republicans are deploying their secret weapon, Trump's son and reason to leave the bar, Don Trump Jr. DJT Jr. is planning to help Republican candidates this summer by taking on a big role in the midterms, which means he's going to have to take some serious time off from... What does he do? What does he do for... He's a suit filler. He's a hair gel storage locker. He's... I'm not sure what he does, but Don Jr. has already started helping, because just a couple weeks ago, he hosted a secret fundraiser for Vice President Mike Pence's older brother, Greg Pence, who was running for Congress in Indiana. That's an exciting double bill. If you love Trump Pence and don't care which ones, I can't wait to find out how his brother Eric helps with the midterms. They gave me a very important role. They gave me a very important role handing out bumper stickers in front of the grocery store. I have lost the bumper stickers. There was a breeze. Meanwhile, I need a lubricant. I need a lip lubricant. What's going on? What are you laughing at? Him over there, baby. And this morning, Trump's former lawyer, Michael Cohen, returned to Capitol Hill for private testimony to the House Intelligence Panel. One thing that might have come up were the checks that Trump wrote to reimburse Cohen for paying off porn star Stormy Daniels. It's an accounting method known in the payroll industry as a crime. Technically. Well, the New York Times got their hands on a bunch of those checks. And the dates are revealing. It turns out Trump would be doing president stuff. Then in the middle of doing all the president stuff, he'd step over here and he would cut a check to Cohen, which the Time describes as the parallel lives Trump was living. And I totally believe the man would live parallel lives. He lies so much. Okay, we're eventually going to find out about his secret family he has stashed in the attic of Trump Tower. And if you don't like Eric and Don Jr., wait till you meet Derek and Ron Jr. That is really frightening.
Whoa.
That is disturbing.
That is pretty wild.
Shut up!